The circle C has center A, 3,5, passes through point B, 8,7. Find an equation for the circle. Let me draw a circle for you. This is the radius. A is 3,5 and B, 8,7. B lies on C. Now, we know that equation of circle is minus A whole square plus I minus B whole square equals to R square. A and B is the center. This is A, 3, and B is 5. Okay. So, only unknown thing is R. Okay. Radius could be found by using a distance formula. We know that that is x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay. So, we can do that. So, it will be 8 minus 3 whole square plus negative 7, negative 5 whole square. 8 minus 3, 5, 5 square is 25 plus negative 7, negative 5, negative 12. Negative 12 square is 144 and square root. Okay. So, R is equals to 169 square root. If you take square root of 169, it will be 13. Okay. So now substitute the values. Minus 3, A is 3, whole square plus Y minus B is 5, whole square equals to 13 square minus 3 whole square plus Y minus 5 whole square equals to 169. This is the required equation of circle. It is just 3 marks, so it is enough. Let us read the statement. The point M and N lies on C such that MN is a chord of C. Given that MN lies above the x-axis and it is parallel to x-axis, and length of MN is 4 square root 22. So this is the length, and MN is parallel to x-axis. Let me sketch the diagram so it will help you out to find the equation of the line passing through M and N. This is y-axis, let's say, and x-axis. Circle has center 3 and 5, so it will be somewhere here. Okay, I'm not roughing the diagram, I'm just sketching it. So it is 3 and 5 is here. This is the center. Center A, that is 3 and 5. This M and N is a chord and it is parallel to x-axis. If we draw a perpendicular from the center A on M and N, on this chord MN, so this perpendicular will bisect it. Okay, let's say this it bisects at x. Okay, so this length will be half of this length, 4 square root 22. So x and n will be 2 square root 22. It will be half of this length, because MN length is 4 square root 22. So XN will be 2 square root 22. Join A with N to make a right triangle. So it is the radius. AN is the radius, and radius we already found, that is 13. Okay. So AX we have to find now. Because this line MN is parallel to X axis, so we need to find only this length D. This one we already know, this is 5. Okay, if we are able to find D, we will plus it and we will find from where it is passing through. We need to find D. By using Pythagoras theorem, we can find D. So D will be equals to D square by Pythagoras theorem, it plus 2 square root 22 whole square equals to 13 square. D square equals to this is 4 multiplied 22, it is 88. This goes to the other side, it will be subtracted. Okay, 169 minus 88. D square is equals to, if you subtract it, you get the answer 81. And square root of 81 is, to get rid of the square, you have to take square root, and answer will be 9. So, we want to find the equation of this line M and N. We can say, if you produce it backward, it is passing through which point? We can say it is 5 already, and 9 is there. Okay, this length is 9. If you add 9 to 5, you will get this line. Okay, equation of this line. Therefore, equation of line passing through M and N is y equals to 5 plus 9. Okay, so it will be equals to y plus 5 plus 9 is 14. So this is the equation of line M and N. And this is the answer for second part.